Hi everybody, I'm Mike with Lenovo, and I'm here with the ThinkCentre M73 series, which is available in three form factors. We have a tower, a small, and the tiny. Today we're going to be replacing the microprocessor and heatsink in the tiny. The process will take about 30 minutes, and you might want to have a little experience working on computers before trying this. The only tool required will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we want to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge, or ESD. For more information on ESD, click the link in the description. Now let's get started.
Remove the screw in the back of the system. Slide the cover forward and remove it. Disconnect the hard drive cable from the hard drive. Disconnect the cable from the system board. Disconnect the front antenna cable from the wireless LAN card. Remove two screws. Slide the hard drive and lift it from the posts. Disconnect the fan cable from the system board. Loosen three screws. These screws are captured so they don't come all the way out. Lift the fan out of the system. Disconnect the speaker cable from the system board. Pull back on the clip and lift the speaker out of the system. Press inward slightly and lift to remove the clip. Using a cross pattern, loosen the screws on the heatsink. Unscrew the first screw halfway and the second one all the way. Then finish unscrewing the first screw. Loosen the third screw halfway, then the fourth all the way, and then back to the third and finish loosening. Lift the heatsink from the system and slide the vent out from the tabs on the chassis. Press down and outward on the handle, then lift to open the processor door. Lift the processor out of the socket. Here we have our new microprocessor we're going to place in the system. When installing the new microprocessor, be sure to align the corner marked with a triangle with the corner marked on the socket. Close the processor door and then press down and inward on the latch to lock it. To install the new thermal paste, we want to put a dot about the size of a pea right in the center. To clean the thermal paste from the heatsink, we're going to use an alcohol swab and just rub it around until all the thermal paste comes off. It may take more than one. These are small. Slide the heatsink under the tab on the chassis, then align the screw holes. Using a cross pattern, tighten the four screws. Tighten the first screw halfway and the second screw all the way. Then the first screw all the way. Tighten the third screw halfway and the fourth screw all the way. Then the third screw all the way. Place the clip over the heatsink and squeeze slightly and press it down into place. Place the speaker in position on the system and press down until the clip locks it in place. Connect the cable to the system board. Place the fan into the system using the screw holes for alignment. And tighten the three screws. Connect the fan cable to the system board. Lower the drive assembly over the posts and slide back to align the screw holes. Install two screws. Connect the front antenna cable to the wireless LAN card. Connect the hard drive cable to the system board. Connect the hard drive cable to the hard drive. Place the cover over the system and slide it back. Install the screw into the back of the system.